Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the United Nations Office of Counter-Terrorism and all partners of the United Nations Countering Terrorist Travel Program, let me extend my warm greetings to everyone joining today's side event. During this event, we will explore the achievements, impact, and lessons learned from the implementation of the program. Just over 2 years ago, in May 2019, we launched this global program to help requesting member states build national capacities to collect, analyze, and use passenger data to detect and counter terrorist movements across the borders. The program was designed in response to the United Nations Security Council Resolution 2396 of December 2017, which obliged states to collect and use Advanced Passenger Information API and Passenger Name Record PNR data in conjunction with national and international databases to detect and interdict the travel of known and suspected terrorists and serious criminals. The City Travel Program provides tailored yet comprehensive support to all member states, establishing and enhancing national capabilities to use traveler information in accordance with international standards, human rights, and relevant privacy laws. However, this is not a simple endeavor. To achieve our objectives, we have leveraged the mandates of and have gathered the best in-house expertise available in a truly all of UN approach. We work in close partnership with the Counter-Terrorism Committee Executive Directorate, the United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime, the International Civil Aviation Organization, the United Nations Office of Information and Communication Technology, and Interpol. This collaboration uniquely positions the program as a UN flagship initiative offering comprehensive capacity building support. And indeed, over the past 2 years alone, 42 countries from across the globe have officially joined the program as beneficiaries. In today's event, you will hear directly from 4 such member states about their experiences with and the impact of the program, namely Azerbaijan, Botswana, Cote d'Ivoire, and The Gambia. We have been working closely with these 4 countries, as well as with other beneficiaries, to collectively contribute to efforts to build a safer world, a world free from terrorism. In support of this goal, we want to learn from our achievements and challenges over the past 2 years to expand the scope and coverage of the program as we move forward. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the City Travel Program has been made possible thanks to the generous support of our donors, the Netherlands, the European Union, the United States, the State of Qatar, Japan, Australia, Germany, India, and Hungary, to whom I am very grateful for their continuing trust in our efforts. Let me conclude by reiterating that properly designed and delivered API and PNR systems that respect human rights are instrumental tools to prevent and counter terrorism and serious crimes. I look forward to hearing more on this from the program partners and beneficiaries. I thank you.